What's up guys, it's Kamala here, and today I'm gonna be teaching you guys how to W key more effectively. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to drop a like and drop a sub. Also, to support me, use creator code Kamali in the item shop. And without further ado, let's get into the video. What's up guys, and as you know, W keying has been one of the biggest playstyles in Fortnite. And it doesn't get easier, it just gets harder as players evolve into the game. Players W key in pubs, they W key in arenas, and you can even find people W keying in big tournaments. That's why today, I'm going to be showing you guys the main steps to W keying and what I think is more effective to win more fights. So first thing we're going to talk about is the beginning game. Depending on how hard you want to W key is how you pick your drop. Just because you're W keying though does not mean that you have to drop hot. A lot of pro players who W key a lot still have a drop that they main. All you're really hoping for though is that you have enough loot to W key efficiently for the rest of the match. Now typically I don't know if I would describe W keying in a beginning game as W keying because most of the times you want to kill everyone that lands at your spot so you can get all the loot. So the first step for the beginning game to getting more kills is landing on the higher elevation. If you can land on a bigger house every time or land somewhere where there's a chest above everything else, you can easily grab a gun and grab a couple kills out the sky if you can kill your opponent in time. Now the second step for the beginning game I'm going to teach you guys is probably one of the most important and it really applies into the rest of the game also. And it's what I call the sneak. The main goal of this is to shoot your opponent before he can even see you or trying to catch your opponent off guard. A mistake I see a lot of people doing is they'll see an opponent and instantly start building towards the opponent. I don't know why, but that makes me so mad. What you're supposed to do is to make sure that a person doesn't know where you are, and you're supposed to try to get the first shots off and make sure you get that little bit of damage. Those damage numbers can be the difference between you killing him and the reason between you shooting him and him only having 1 HP. Just know, in the beginning game, you need to play the fights differently because you most likely don't have as much mats as you would in a regular fight like mid game or end game. Now let's say you finally won your spot and now you're getting ready to really W key. What you need to do is have a loot pool that you prefer. For example, if I'm playing, I normally use 2 heals, then I use an AR and a shotgun, and usually like some heavy sniper or RPG, just any other utility that I have at the time. If you're playing a game mode like arenas or any tournaments, it usually has siphon, so you get 50 health every kill, so you don't usually need to run too many heals. Or if you're a crazy madman, you can go and use no heals, but that's just really stupid. Now that you have everything you need to W key effectively for the rest of the match or for mid game, obviously it's time to start W keying. Now the first step I have for you guys is gonna be the same step that I told you guys in beginning game, and it is the sneak. The purpose of this again is to always get a lot of pre-damage shots off on your opponent. You do not want to fight your opponent or start box fighting him before you get at least one shot on your opponent. You want to know what your opponent is working with. What I see a lot of pro players do, they'll see their opponent far away, and instead of shooting at them and getting some shots off, they will continue to get close so they get a perfect beam on their opponent. Now, in doing this, you can either have the fight ended already just from your AR, or you can have your opponent weak, and all you have to do is find the best way to get in his box. Now, let's say you went to beam your opponent, but you didn't get any shots off. The best thing to do is to spray at his box. The reason you're doing this is most of the times you're gonna at least get one shot to hit your opponent. The reason for this though is so you can tell if your opponent either has shield or no shield. I know if you know your opponent has no shield, you're gonna play the fight way more aggressive and try to get over quick. Whereas in if he does have shield or it doesn't break, you're gonna play the fight a little bit more slowly and be more careful. Now whether you hit your opponent or not, it's time for you to start fighting because he definitely know that you're there. So this is a second step, and it's to check your utilities on your mats. The reason you're doing this is because you don't want to go into a fight and not use what you have. For example, you go into a fight and then you didn't notice you had an RPG like halfway throughout your fight, and you already waste your mats doing a whole bunch of unnecessary moves. That would be really bad because you could have saved mats by using an RPG and it could have easily get the damage done. And that goes for any other utility that you can use to help win the fight. Also, the reason I'm telling you to check your mats is because you don't want to go into the mats overbuilding or doing a whole bunch of extra stuff and notice that you have no more mats. This is actually something I struggle with a lot. I always end up running out of mats and never noticing it. So please just keep on paying attention to your mats. If you don't have enough, sometimes you can back off from the fight. It's not always easy, but sometimes you can really do it. Now, third step is what I call the approach. The approach is basically how you're going to approach your opponent upon fighting them. This all depends. Did your opponent box up? Then you're most likely going to have to box fight him. Or if your opponent starts to build higher, you're most likely going to have to try to PG him or just break him down. Now this is why I stress practicing in-game box fighting. Now this is why I always say in-game that being a better box fighter is better than being a better PG warrior is because you can force someone to box fight. You cannot force someone to build fight you. What I mean by this is, say if you go to build fight someone and all they do is sit there and box up, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna keep on building? No, you have to go down there and box fight him if you really wanna kill him. Or you see someone building a lot, looking like Faye Sway, and all you do is break them down and start box fighting them once again. Now we have to talk about what you're doing inside of your fight. The first tip to box fighting, or just fighting in general when you're WKing someone, is working on your angles. You want to try to get every angle to where you can shoot your opponent, and it makes it harder for your opponent to shoot you. For example, if you watch someone like Mitro, he always stands to the side of someone's box instead of the full middle of it, so if that person edits out, he can get an easy right hand peek, or he can do some other trick to have a different angle on his opponent. Now, something like angles isn't something I can easily just teach you. I cannot tell you every angle in the game because there's always different situations that you're gonna be in. This you will acquire over time after getting into a numerous amount of fights. You will start noticing when your opponent is gonna edit, where your opponent is gonna be, and where you need to have yourself at the time of the fight. You're gonna start noticing a lot, especially when you start to improve. Now, let's say you got a lot of shots on your opponent and he's really weak. Your opponent is now in a box, or you're just at the end of the fight in general. Now, this is usually where better ping players have it easy. As soon as your opponent is weak and he's in a box, you can easily try and take his wall and do some piece control. Now, this is why I tell you guys to practice so much, like the Mangrove Classic, or just getting a cone inside your opponent's box. I'm gonna put a map up so you guys can go practice those moves. Those are like what I call the finishing moves. I really think it's crucial to get good at doing stuff like this, especially if you have lower ping, because once you get your opponent wall and you get something in his box, it's going to be really hard for him to react in time. Also, I've taught you guys piece control a numerous amount of times, and you can go and look at my old videos how to get better at it. But let's say you don't have good ping, and your opponent is weak, and you need to get in his box. There's always a whole bunch of different options, like box exploits and phasing methods. For example, like the Mitro Classic or some of Cypher PK's moves. I've seen a Cesarian upload a video recently on a lot of phasing tricks, so you guys can go look at that if you want high ping. It would really work better for you guys. And for the last tip, I've seen this way too much. A lot of people will WKey, and when they get weak, they will still make an edit and go for a shot, basically 50-50ing the opponent, especially when you guys already have heals and you don't attempt to use them. Now, what I mean by this is if you're in a fight and you're getting a lot of damage done, and it's also doing a lot of damage to you, and you have heals, the best thing to do is to try and heal. Now let's say if your opponent is being really aggressive and you still need to heal, what you need to do is do a little bit of tunnels and pop a heal at a time until your opponent is kind of lost in where you are. The worst thing that I see a lot of players do, and it used to be one of my mistakes until I actually heard Booga say it, and what I see a lot of players still do is build higher when you're weak. You do not want to build higher when you're weak. The reason is you're gonna be able to be seen by a lot more opponents in a game, meaning you're probably gonna get third party from other opponents when you're trying to heal, making it even harder for you to win the fight or pop your heals. So this is why you need to go in creative and practice your tunneling skills even if you're not an endgame or a scrim type of player. Usually, after a couple tunnels, your opponent will lose you into the fight, and you'll be able to get a couple heals off. And in doing that, you basically just reset the fight, or you've healed when your opponent have it and it's going to be another easy kill for you. So guys, if you're going to WKey, make sure you have a really good practicing routine, and as well as you're trying to improve your mechanics as best as you can. I have a lot of videos that I show how to improve your mechanics, and there's also a couple practice routines that you can use to get better every day. So as you can tell from this video, you're going to need to practice your AR aim for when you do the sneak, get into more fights so you can get good at doing different angles and killing people easier, as well as practicing your mechanics so you can get better at piece controlling, doing Mongrel Classics, or practicing those box exploits to easily get inside someone's box. And lastly, something that I do a lot that I really thought helped me improve, and it's to watch other players WKey. I always watch a lot of Mitro videos on YouTube of him dropping 30 bombs or 20 bombs, or watch Mongrel drop 30 bombs as well. It really helps you, and it really helps you implement moves that you see him do. Sometimes I'll watch them, notice a move they do, and end up doing it in game myself subconsciously and not even notice that I did it without even practicing or looking at them do it. So what you can do is, every night before you go to sleep, watch a couple YouTube videos of players WKing, or just watch a stream of somebody WKing and see what they do while you're falling asleep. If you guys follow most of these tips, as well as keep playing the game consistently and practicing consistently, in no time, you guys would be WKing kids easily without even having to think about what you're doing.
Thank you guys so much for watching, and if you enjoyed, don't forget to drop a like and drop a sub.
Also, to support me, use creator code Kamali in the item shop. It's Kamali, and I'm out.